हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज हर्षित वर्मा एंड आई एम अ थर्ड ईयर अंडरग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग। आई एम इंटर्निंग इन डॉक्टर रेड्डीज लेबोरेटरी दिस समर 2020। आई हैव प्रीवियसली वर्ड ऑन विद न्यूक्लियर पावर कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया लिमिटेड तारापुर एंड हिंदुस्तान पेट्रोलियम कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड HPCL रांची। सो दीज आर माई एक्सपीरियंसेज विद टेक्नोलॉजिकल बैकग्राउंड इंडस्ट्री टिल नाउ। So let's carry on to the preparation strategies for the intern session 2021 that you need to do as in order to go for a wonderful companies and build your careers. Depending on the preparation strategies for the company coming on to the internship season, what you need to do is you need to have your wonderful resume that you need to prepare during the summer break. So now this is corona time, so I think you all must have been through the resume making and all the sessions, and I hope you build your resume to the point, you focuses every part of your project and do not try to mention extra points in order to look the resume more lengthy, because these extra points aren't as good as you seem. The thing is, the interviewer wants you to be specific, so the projects that you have done, be specific. What the impact that you have made in the project, how does the project benefit the society or the industry, whichever it is relevant upon, and what is the subject of the project. And so keep your resume to the point. So that is what I can tell you for your resume. Keep it to the point, and that's it, so that you can defend this resume in your interview. All the technical interviews and HR interviews that often takes place in the company are being revolved around your resume. So your resume is one of the most important strategy. You can say it as a strategy, or you can say it as a tool, which is very very informative, and it decides your journey in the internship season. So after the resume comes another most important part, is your GD. GD is group discussion. So what I can say is, every technical company that comes for a chemical engineering background has resume shortlisting and then followed by a group discussion, and large number of students are being removed from group discussion. So what you need to do is, you need to prepare the GD part thoroughly. Make a group of your friends, you can practice with on GD with, and then take ample of topics from the GD as well, from the internet and various sources present. There are various sites which offers you the topics for strategical GDs and business GDs and analytical GDs. So practice them all, and then I hope with a group that you will make of 4 to 5 or 6 to 8 people. And in these pandemic times, try to be use Google Meets as an interactive tool, so that you can connect on and then carry on with your GD discussion, and I hope ki you will then excel in your GDs. So then after the GD, what comes is the technical aspects of the interview. So for the technical aspects, what I can say for a chemical engineering background is, you need to prepare 3 important subjects. One is ESO 201, engineering thermodynamics, which is the most important subject. And then comes the fluid mechanics, CHE 211, and then the CHE 221, I remember, is chemical engineering thermodynamics. These 3 are the most important subjects for the internship session. All the companies will ask mostly on thermodynamics. They will ask you, what is your favorite subject? You will probably be answering thermodynamics or fluid mechanics, as you are sitting for a technical profile for a chemical company. You will not be saying that my favorite subject is math. So it depends upon you can say that. So you must excel in these 2 subjects. Try to study them thoroughly, not only the bookish part, also try to focus on the practical aspects of the concepts that are being provided in the book. So be practical. What I can say, try to watch as many as practical videos that are possible on YouTube. Action Lab is one such YouTube channel where you can find various ample amounts of experiment with the fluid mechanics and thermodynamics used in that. So try to be more creative. Try to look the world outside the books. Don't be in the books. So that's what the interviewer wants. The company where you will be interning is real based problems. So there the problems that are coming would be real based. It's not like the bookish problems you will be able to going to solve. There are many complications in real life aspects. So that you need to see. Try to utilize most of the YouTube. Try to find figure out fluid mechanics part. from the thermodynamics part, more important part is the thermodynamic cycles, entropy. These are the most important questions that are being asked in an interview. In the fluid mechanics portion, the major amount of questions are asked from internal and external flow, and covering your major part upon Navier-Stokes equation and Bernoulli equation. So I think you need to be well versed with Navier-Stokes, Bernoulli. How does Bernoulli derive from Navier-Stokes? What are the approximations? So do not try to focus on formulas. What I can say, focus on what are the assumptions that are being taken in order to conclude a formula. So that is the most important thing. The assumptions, the assumptions are nothing but they are the deviations from the reality. So that is what I am talking about till now. So the assumptions are not, but they are the deviations from the ideality. So that is what the industry needs. So what are the assumptions that you are needing, and how can you remove these assumptions so that your model can become more close to the real one? So that's what I can say. Practice more on thermodynamics, fluid mechanics part. There is one course also, CHE261. It's chemical process industries. It's you will think that it is it would be a most important course, like it is a talks about industry. But as far as I know, the interviewer don't ask much about these questions. They will ask general questions. What are the melting point of sulfur? How does the coal? How does the crude oil distillator refractionator work? And how does these things work? So I think these things will be asked from that subject, not in detail. So you can just skim through that subject, no need to go into that detail. So I think these three to four subjects, I think the first of all is thing, you need to work more harshly on this engineering thermodynamics, because all the core companies that comes for you comes for as well as mechanical also. So chemical and mechanical have one course in common, that is ESO 201, engineering thermodynamics. So major amount of question that would be asked is from engineering thermodynamics, not your chemical engineering thermodynamics. Basic question that can be asked are, what are the fugacity, how is phase equilibria. So I think as a chemical engineer you all know, so that's not the point to go from the books. So study well. Try to connect things, try to go on to the real problems, and focus on how to connect the how our assumptions arrived and how to remove those assumptions. So that is what I can say. I think these amounts of technical aspect knowledge, I think will work you in your interview, and you will ace your interview. You will ace your technical interview. So talking of my working experience in Dr. Reddy's laboratories this summer, it was very nice. It was a nice experience to me. It was work from home. I was firstly, when I heard ki it would be going to be taking place as a work from home, I was excited. But the atmosphere, I think, is fine. You will get a chance to interact with a lot of people from all over the organization. So that will help you to grow as with the organization. You will see in your intern, what I have saw is your small amount of contribution to the industry will be propagated deeply inside the industry. Many people will get affected, your work will be analyzed by many people, and yeah, they will be keenly interested in trying to go on to their work and carry on the research forward. So what I think is, it's a good experience to work with a corporate technical intern. You will see how your small contributions will go very deeply penetrated into the industry, and they will be used very well as well. So coming on to the other questions list, the first one is, what skills do I need to get an intern into the core companies, especially what are they looking for in a candidate? So what are they looking is, you need to better connect what are the studies in the books as well as in the real life. You need to make a connection. That is what I said earlier. How are these assumptions made? What are the deviations from the ideal model, so that the real model it can be implemented? If you will analyze these things, ki how a real model works and what are the assumptions that are being applied, into which you can perform calculations and analytical calculations that you do in your exams or in your books. So that is what they need. Ki what is the desire for this company, and how strongly you interrelate, correlate what are given in the books to the thing that can be applied universally outside the real life. So that is what they require, that is what they seek. Like some of the problems, like scaling up of a process or scaling down of a process, as a chemical engineer they will see how you scale up a process. So that's the thing. So what are the problems, what are the complications in the scale up? So these things they ask in an interview, or they also ask, how do you connect the problems? So that's all they require, and the also the depth into the core knowledge, the core subjects they also see. So that's the most required niche. So the another thing is, what are the different options available in a given profile as in a company? So it depends upon company to company. This is like Dr. Reddy's comes for this time it comes for an R&D, but since work from home due to the coronavirus pandemic, they splitted their work into data analytics, R&D, and finance. So these are the three profiles. So it depends upon the company. Like ITC, this time ITC came for techno manager profile and data analytics. So it also opened for MTS department also. Like HUL comes for supply chain and R&D. So these are depends upon the company to company, year to year. So what these profiles comes for? So it depends. And you will be let you know by the SPO key what profile they are seeking the students. Another is, can we get a good placement and internship by focusing only on coursework? Yeah, मतलब कि you can get a decent job, but only on coursework, I don't think you will get a good placement until you need a good internship. You should have important projects in your curriculum, and then you should be good in communication skills, and all these things matter. Only doing coursework and getting A grades in these, I don't think you will get a landing a good job. So you need to carry on with good projects, good interns, and with good communication skill, you will able to ace a good job. Is it necessary to convert to M.Tech to get a core job? I don't think for getting a core job, B.Tech, for many companies, like in chemical, all the companies come for B.Tech students. The only company that comes for dual degree is IOCL. But what I think is, instead of wasting 1 year on M.Tech profile, what you can do is you can prepare for GATE, and then you can go for PSU companies like GATE, DRDO, and ONGC as well. So I think it's not necessary to convert into an M.Tech into get a good core job. The good core job is only one profile, that is IOCL, that is coming to Kanpur. So yeah, you can prepare for GATE by saving your 1 year time in M.Tech. So what I prefer is to prepare for GATE instead of going for an M.Tech. Else it's your desire. So how to get a research intern in good universities? So getting a good research internship in an university, what you can do is you can first of all prepare, you should first of all prepare your career CV. CV is different from resume, so I think you need to look on to how to make a CV. And then after preparing a CV, you need good amount of projects in your field. And then you can start applying in various programs like TAMU, DAT, CHARPARK, MITEX. So these programs have different deadlines, and then you can start applying onto that. And then I think by the end of February and by the end of January, you will start receiving the calls. So I think this is the right way to go for a research intern in good universities. Or what you can do is you can do apping, you can start apping, you can mail professors, you can. So then what's the thing is, you need to mail 1,000 professors in order to get a response. So that's what I do not prefer. Just go for the programs like DAT, MITEX, TAMU, and CHARPARK. So that's the thing that you can go for research intern in good universities. So thank you.